Hello, and thanks for tuning in to our 2-Minute Tuesday series. I'm Rahul Martinez, a flight instructor here at Aviator Zone Academy, and today I'll be covering several very important gyroscopic instruments you might find inside an aircraft. Let's get started. If you've seen our previous episodes, you're probably already familiar with the pitot-static system and the various speed indicators inside the cockpit, all which give vital information to a pilot. Gyroscopic instruments are no different. What makes these so special is the fact that they have a mechanical gyroscope incorporated into them, allowing them to have rigidity in space and precession, which gives us accurate information on an aircraft's attitude. Now, before we get into the instruments, it's important to understand what attitude is. Not to be confused with altitude, attitude is the angular difference measured between an airplane's axis and the Earth's horizon. Before we dive in further, rigidity in space refers to the principle that a gyroscope remains in a fixed position in the plane in which it is spinning. For example, a bicycle spinning at a fast speed tends to be highly stable compared to riding a bicycle at a much lower speed, due to the principle of rigidity in space. Precession is the tilting or turning of a gyro in response to a deflective force. Since a gyro obtains rigidity in space, you can say that gyros don't like to be moved. When a force is applied to a gyro, it will not be instantly felt, but rather felt 90 degrees later in the direction of rotation. In our gyroscopic instruments, precession is caused by both friction within the gyro and by aircraft maneuvering, including turns, climbs, descents, and even acceleration and deceleration. The three gyroscopic instruments found in most, if not all, aircraft are attitude indicator, heading indicator, and the turn coordinator. These instruments are powered by the electrical and vacuum system found inside the aircraft. The attitude indicator provides a clear picture of what's happening with the aircraft's pitch and bank angle, and is powered by the vacuum system. The heading indicator provides the direction in which the aircraft is headed and is aligned with the magnetic compass. It is also powered by the vacuum system. The turn coordinator provides the rate and quantity of turns, which allows the pilot to see if the aircraft is in a coordinated standard rate turn. It's the only gyroscopic instrument powered by the electrical system. Keep in mind, these instruments do have their limitations and errors. For example, the attitude indicator becomes unreliable when banking more than 100 degrees and when pitching more than 60 degrees. During accelerations and decelerations, the attitude indicator will tend to pitch up or pitch down. Have a question about gyroscopic instruments or a suggestion for our next video? Leave them in the comments, and we'll see you next Tuesday.